Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Well, today we're going to have a look at Migs Field with update 11. We have Migs Field back in the game again, and I haven't seen it for a long time since Flight Simulator X, or maybe before that actually. But today we're going to have a look at Migs Field. We're going to walk around, do a little bit of exploring. We've got the cityscape in the background there. Chicago, which just looks absolutely stunning. The water from here, got the little water effect, the ripple effects on the water, looks absolutely amazing. We've got plenty of little airport cars, police cars, that looks quite nice. Little police Land Rover there, or Jeep. Okay, so let's go for a bit of a walk around Migs Field. Do a little bit of exploring and see what we've actually got here now. Now, it is not smooth, I have to tell you that. I've got my Xbox controller here that I'm moving around with, but it's not smooth. It is a little bit blocky, I have to say that. I mean, that file of Chicago, I mean the cache from the Chicago, not just the little airport, but all the Chicago skyscrapings and buildings, it is really taking a toll. Okay, it is. You're really paying it for a price for that in regards to frame rate. I think we really are. It is quite blocky just moving around like this. Now look, we got a little tinny boat here, a little truck, and a caravan. I would have liked to have been able to go inside the caravan, maybe do a little bit of camping. Being a camping sort of a person, I would have liked to spend the night at Migs Field. In my little caravan, that would have been quite good if I could have got into the caravan. But we've got a lovely little truck, and we've got a little tinny boat here. Go out, do a little bit of fishing, catch a few fish for breakfast, would be quite nice. Okay, so let's have a look over here. We've got a couple of dudes hanging around, a couple of workers. Hi mate, how's it going? Love those sunglasses, man, they're really cool. Very nice sunglasses. Now we have the terminal buildings here, not these ones, but there's some others down here, I think. Well, we got some nice fuel trucks, they look really nice. Beautiful vehicles around the place. That truck looks really cool, very nice looking truck. I don't know what sort of brand it is or what it represents, but it's nicely modeled, I've got to say. Everything is nicely modeled. A little bit of a fuel farm here. The vehicles are very nicely modeled. We've got a tarmac cleaner here. Scrubs the tarmac, cleans the tarmac. Maybe it's also a snow remover as well, to get the snow off the runway, maybe in the winter time. I think Chicago does have a lot of snow in the winter time. Now we can't go into the control tower, but you can see inside the control tower. The minute you try to go inside the control tower, there is nothing in there. It's that sort of new technology that looks like it's all three-dimensional and everything, but it's actually not. It's very, very clever. This is about as close as we can get to the control tower. If we try to go in, it will place us up on the roof of the control tower. And it's like that with all the buildings here at Migs Field. Very, very cleverly done, but unfortunately we can't go into the control tower. But we can get close up and we can have a look around. We got a chair, we got our computers, but it's okay. Look at the view of the city from up the top of the control tower. There's the big football field over there, the skyscrapers, the cityscape is just stunning. Okay, so let's have a look down here. Down this way, we've got all the office buildings, and this is the main sort of terminal here, or public terminal. The door is open, we can see inside, and it looks amazing. Looks very beautifully modeled, but again, we can't go in. If we try to go in, it will place us at the top of the building. But we got some signs up there. Chicago Park District. Looks really nice inside. It's a shame we can't go in, have a little bit of a walk around. But beautifully done. Okay, this must be the sort of the main driveway in, the main entrance to the Miggs Field. Little plane parked here, a little Cessna. But you can notice when I swing the views around to have a look around, it is really blocky. So I'm going to try flying a plane over here very soon, and we'll see what the frame rate is like. But I think I'm going to take a hit. I think the computer is going to take a hit with such a big intense scenery file here. So this is the car park. We come up here. Very iconic sort of building here at the end of Miggs Field. Is it an observatory? I always thought it was an observatory, but I don't know. There's a lot of solar panels around. Is it a conservatory? I don't know. I'm not sure what that building actually is. So I'll have to Google that. Some other very iconic buildings over here. But the cityscape is just amazing. I just don't know how smooth it's going to be if I come and fly around this area or fly over the city in a little plane. But let's have a look at the football field. Very, very iconic. A lot of these. Look at those skyscrapers. Oh my gosh. That is incredible, isn't it? Now, have a look at this football field, because this is full of bugs. Well, it has a bug, if you like. There we go, there's the football field. Now, I don't know if it's like this today or not, what it really looks like in real, but I think they have groundsmen and caretakers there who do the weeding and the trimming of all the gardens. I don't think it would look like this, guys. I really don't think there'd be fully grown trees in the middle of the field. Now, this is the same bug that I have in my Renton factory. And I was so disappointed, so looking forward to seeing the Renton factory when I downloaded it. And this is what I got. The factory buildings and everything were just full of trees. Very, very bad. And it is a bug. It is sloppy. And it should not be like this. It should not happen. So I'm pretty disappointed that this is happening in Miggs Field. And I ended up deleting my Renton factory because it just looked so hideous. It just looked stupid. And as far as I know to date, there is still no bug fix for it, which is a real shame, because I'm 100% sure I'm not the only one that gets this bug in the Renton factory or here. But will it ever be fixed? I don't know. I probably doubt it. If it hasn't been fixed by now, you're probably stuck with it. So there we go. It probably looks really nice from a great height, that stadium, but it is completely spoiled by that bug of being full of trees. Okay, now we've got a marina over here. Let's take a look at the marina. Now, I've owned a boat, a launch, and I've launched it. I've put it in the water at the marina here in Auckland many, many times. But I've got to tell you, I've never seen a marina with grass growing in it. Sand, stones, and grass in the marina. Looks like the marina is on dry land, and this is not good, guys. It looks hideous. It looks terrible. The water here is nice. When the water is done, where the water is done, it is beautiful. I just love it. I know there is a high tide and a low tide, but even at low tide, you've still got to be able to take your boat out, guys. How much damage is done to your boat sitting on the mud and the stones and the grass? Just sitting down on the earth like that, it does damage. It is very bad for the hull of your boat. and there should be water in the marina. That's it, guys. I'm sorry, but that is pretty poor. Pretty poor rendering there. So it's another bug. I don't know if it will ever be fixed, but it is not good enough for a marina. So we can't enjoy the view there. We can't enjoy that because it just looks weird. So let's come over here. What's over here? Some more beautiful iconic buildings. Just amazing. So there's the city. The city looks beautiful. You've got the railway lines there. Maybe this is the big railway station, because the railway lines appear to be going straight into this building. So maybe this is the big Chicago railway station. Can't see where they go in there. They just hit the brick wall. But the city buildings, the skyscrapers, absolutely stunning. Just beautiful. The stadium is a mess. The marina is a mess. But as a little field to fly in and out of, I'm sure it's fine. It's nice. It's nice having Meigs Field back again. It's nice having Meigs Field back again. The field itself looks okay. It looks nicely modeled. A lot of nice ground vehicles around. The terminals, the buildings are beautiful. So just as a little field to fly in and out of, it will be fantastic to have it back. Just beautiful. But don't start sightseeing around the city or start looking at the adjacent scenery, because it just looks weird. So that is Meigs Field, guys. That is Meigs Field. Probably on one of my next videos, I'm going to fly around the city and have a look, because it is a big city and it is a big place. Look at all those buildings and skyscrapers that are rendered. Now, I have my settings turned down quite low, okay? My settings are not turned up very high. But look at this. Imagine what it would look like if my settings were turned up full. Oh my gosh, I probably couldn't even swing my view around. It would be that blocky and frame rate intense. It would be that taxing on my frame rate and my computer. I hate to think what it would do to my frame rate. But overall, it looks very, very nice, but a little bit disappointing in places. So let's come over here. I'm going to take a screenshot for my video of Meigs Field. I think that looks sort of quite nice there. Turn off my ugly dial and take a screenshot. Right. Okay, guys, let me know what you think in the comments below. Is it smooth for you? Have you flown around Chicago? Is it nice and smooth, or is it blocky? Let me know what you think in the comments below. Take care, guys. Cheers. See you soon.